Hi everyone, we're here at the Bobco Conservatory of Music and we have an amazing concert lined up for you tonight.
These live performances are made possible by ticket sales. We encourage you to make a donation online in lieu of purchasing a ticket.
Your contribution also helps us with instrument repair, ensemble touring, bringing guest artists to campus, purchasing music, and enhancing our classroom technology.
So please either scan the QR code or click the link in the description.
All right, it's almost time for the show. So grab a seat, or rather, your comfiest spot on the couch, and thank you for supporting us here at the Bob Cole Conservatory of Music.
Thank you for being here. I'm James Barrera, saxophone professor here at the Bob Cole Conservatory. Really appreciate people coming out. This semester for our studio recital, we're doing pieces that don't have piano, which I would say would all be chamber music, but one piece is technically not really chamber music. I told them to tune back there. Maybe that was a mistake. Okay, so part of being a saxophone major here is we have a saxophone quartet class that I teach, and usually we have one group, which is the group that's playing at the end, but this semester I formed a second quartet with new students. So these are all people, I don't think any of them have played quartet before, but they're doing a really great job. So they're the first up. They're going to play two quartets that are for, instead of with a soprano sax, it's with an alto sax. So alto, alto, tenor, baritone. And as saxophonists, our instrument was invented in the late 1800s, so we missed out on Mozart and Bach and a lot of the composers that other instruments take for granted. And so, but in order to have an education that's equivalent to what a string player does, you know, we play a fair amount of transcriptions. So these two pieces are transcriptions from the Romantic era, but lucky for you, we have a lot of super modern pieces too. So this concert is a mix of the old and the very, very new. So I hope you enjoy it. So we'll have the first group come out here. It's Michael Quintero on alto, Cesar Lepe on alto, Izzy Avina on tenor, and Dante Navarro on the baritone sax. Thank you. quick program note, there is, after this piece, after the next work, there's going to be another duet that's completely my fault that I forgot to add to the program, but there will be one more duet. So I'll let you know what that is afterwards. Okay, the next, boy. Okay, the next piece is, so the next piece is for saxophone and electronics, but the electronics are from the audience. And so hopefully you guys should have gotten a QR code in your program. If you didn't, you can maybe raise your hand and someone can bring you one. You can scan that with your phone, okay? You're good, Mark. So what you're gonna need, so the genesis of this piece is Mark Engbertson is a saxophonist, and his wife is also a saxophonist, Susan Fancher. And Mark has written many pieces for saxophone, and they're all super hard. And she asked him to write a piece with electronics, but one that didn't require setup in the hall, because if you play a piece with electronics, you have to coordinate with the people in the hall, you need a microphone, you have to do sound checks or speakers. So she asked him to come up with something that would be setup-wise easier to do. So he came up with this idea because everyone has phones these days. And so what's gonna happen is Kiara, from her laptop here, is going to be streaming to the link that you have. And so what you all need to do is just turn the volume up on your phone. Put your phone in do not disturb mode so that you can have the volume, but if someone sends you Facebook chat, you won't get the little thing in there. What's going to happen is that she's gonna start the live stream and the music is gonna come to your phones, but in a delay. So, you know, when you watch a live stream, you don't see the identical thing. So you'll hear the sound coming from throughout the audience. And then she has a pedal, and at the indicated times in the music, she's gonna send her sound. So you'll hear her playing live, and then there'll be portions that are sent through the live stream that you'll hear as an echo on your phones. And I think that's it, right? That's all that covers it? All right, so I'll hand it over to Kiara.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Moving along, the next group is Dante Navarro and Izzy Avina, and they're playing a piece from Six Duos by Frederick Kuhlau, which were originally written for the group.
Thank you.
so they're going to get, we'll just go to it. Okay, so the next piece is by John Cage. It's called 4-5, the word for number 5. It was commissioned by John Sampin, which if you're a saxophone nerd type, you know, he teaches at Bowling Green University and is really known for new music. John Cage, probably his most famous piece that if you know about these things, is 4 minutes and 33 seconds. And it's a piece, it's 3 movements, but there's no sound. It's, the whole thing is rests. So you're just supposed to sit at the piano and you put a timer on, and when the timer's done, then you just turn the page and then you do the next thing. And so his music is, experimental. It kind of challenges you to think about what the nature of music is. And this piece is not like that. There is sound, and it is indeterminate, or aleatoric, meaning that what's going to happen is up to the player, and it's pretty much random. It's always going to be different every single time. And so what they're going to be doing is, this piece is 12 minutes long. And it's always 12 minutes long. It's exactly 12 minutes long because you have a stopwatch. You turn your stopwatch on, and there are notes. There is one note that they can play between certain time periods, and they can play either a long note that is very quiet, or a short note that is very loud. And that's basically the piece. You are told you're not supposed to bother trying to play in tune. So as he says, look at the word crazy as a unison can be a unison of 2 different notes, basically. So Daniel in the corner over there is going to start them off, so they're going to get their timers up. And I hope you enjoy 4-5 by John.
Thank you. Thank you.
the end, and the proverbial best for last here, we have the Carnelian Quartet. So this group is part of a series of standing quartets that I've been doing for, I don't know, quite a while now. And so every year I have four students and we do quartet. Sometimes it's the same group of students year after year. In this case, two of them did it last year. And so this group, this year we went to the Navy Band International Saxophone Symposium in Washington, D.C., and they played on the College Quartet Series. The group last year also went and they did a masterclass with the Habanera Saxophone Quartet, and Colby this year did a masterclass at the Navy Band with as a soloist. So the piece that they're going to play by Ida Gotkovsky is a, wow, like a titanic work for the saxophone. And Gotkovsky, she really writes, you know, bangers for the saxophone. They're monster things. It's unbelievable the amount of sound she demands from us to generate. So I'm really impressed with how well they've done with this piece. It's definitely one of the masterworks for our instrument. So without further ado, I bring you the Carnelian Quartet.
Thank you. Thank you.
coming. If you want, you can. We have a lot more concerts. All these folks are doing recitals. There's a saxophone ensemble concert. Probably other things I'm forgetting. But your best bet is to follow us on social media. We're on Facebook and Instagram. So you can always find our concerts there and whatever we're up to. So thank you so much for coming, and see you in the future.